Thank you so much.
It's perfect. Thank you. If I could have anything that I could have, I would have that no one in the city goes hungry or in this country goes hungry. Because in Canada, we're in Canada. Like, it shouldn't be this way.
From this kitchen, part of the Ottawa Mission shelter,
beauty.
Chef Ric Watson feeds thousands of people in need every day.
Nick, what time is the food truck coming down?
And he says there's more demand than ever.
It would be here before 10 o'clock.
Okay. When COVID hit, our meal numbers just gradually just kept going up and up and up. As of today, we're putting out 2,600 meals a day. The pandemic has people, they can't afford to buy food. And, you know, so many people lost their jobs. So it's just people are going hungry.
And with the situation as bad as it is, Chef Ric knows that just feeding people isn't enough.
Okay, we're going to start. Is that cool? Okay.
And so the other thing he does here is to train people how to cook so they can find work and support themselves.
Is everyone comfortable if I take my mask off?
Yes.
So, thank you. So today we're going to make eggplant parm.
To get into Chef Ric's cooking class, there's really only one specific requirement, that you're in a tough spot in your life and you need help.
They want to be self-sufficient. They don't want to have to count on social services or stand in a line for a slice of bread. You know, they want to be able to support themselves and their families.
Take Ernie McIntyre, for example. He's 57 with a wife and daughter. And when he was unable to find work during the pandemic, he tells me he got desperate.
Man, I just sold dope, drugs.
Right.
And that's it. That's all I did. I did that. And if I get goods and I can sell it to make some money, I do it. Whatever it took to get myself some money.
We're going to put a little bit of the Parmesan on, okay?
Then a friend told Ernie about Chef Ric's cooking class.
Ernie, go find some milk, please. We're going to put some milk.
Ernie applied, and for the last 6 months, he's been training nonstop. Now he has a job offer cooking at the Salvation Army.
So this, to me, is like a light turned on, and I can walk through a different kind of door. So that's why I'm so happy, because I know it's not far from home. It's just walking distance. So everything should be good in the next few months.
There we go. Great. You're going to put another layer of sauce, okay? We show that we care. I've had people in my arms crying. We show compassion, forgiveness. I always say, I don't care about your past, I care about your future. When you cut the eggplant parm, you should see the layers in it. You know what I mean?
And Chef Ric understands the kinds of struggles his students are going through because he's lived many of them himself.
So it's a very attractive dish. When I was growing up, my mother was mentally ill. She was paranoid schizophrenic. So it was a very tough life. I remember at the age of around 10 years old, I was responsible for doing the grocery shopping for the house. And I could barely see over the cart going down the aisle. And then at the age of 14, my mother told me I had to leave the house to move out. So that was a pretty traumatic time. It's going to look good, eh?
Chef Ric couch surfed. As a teenager, he was homeless. He needed help to survive, and he found it in a kitchen.
Beauty.
At Queen's University in Kingston.
I remember sometimes I would sleep in the storeroom because I had nowhere to sleep. And then in the morning, come out and just start working. And it felt like a home. And one of the people that worked there reached out to me and said, you know, you can do better. You can go to school. You could be someone. And I never had anyone tell me that before. I think we can do the final layer now, okay?
Chef Ric followed that advice and became a chef.
First.
And now he wants to be that voice for his students. Like Casey Pink. She was a teenager when she got into drugs after her father died.
I wasn't eating, so I was very emaciated, and just drugs was the most important thing to me. I really didn't have any friends. I wasn't in touch with my family.
It's when I hear Casey's story, I realize how much this kitchen can really help people.
I don't want my daughter to go through what I went through. Hopefully I'll be able to break the cycle for her, you know? But I care more about my daughter than I did about, the substances that I was addicted to. I'm able to be a positive role model for her, you know? It's just starting. I'm just starting now, but I'm making better choices, and if I can keep going with it and make her proud, you know?
Casey, do you want to come over here? And you're going to start to assemble, okay?
Because of this course, Casey has found work cooking at the same shelter where she used to eat when she needed help.
That's awesome. There we go.
90% of students who graduate from Chef Rick's six-month class find jobs.
Put that there, you got it.
They leave here with all the certifications they need to work in a commercial kitchen.
So you're enjoying your new job?
That's kind of an understatement. I'm in love with my new job.
Are you? I'm happy. It becomes like a family.
It does. You love them.
A lot of us that don't have families understand that.
Exactly.
While these students finish their coursework and get set to graduate, there are others ready to start.
You're liking it?
Yeah?
Yeah, good.
With COVID, a growing number of people need a second chance, and that's what Chef Rick is all about.
Kind of my first time grilling this much chicken.
Yeah, I bet you it is.
This is your life's work. This is your mission.
Yes, absolutely. And it will be till the day that I die. Do we have some fresh basil?
Yes.
We're all the same when it comes down to it. We just want to be loved. We just need people to care about us, and we need to care about other people. It's a simple process, really. Good.
Nick Purden, CBC News, Ottawa.